see.
So are we ready to get going? So good afternoon, everybody. My name is Melissa Healy. I'm a lawyer at Carmen Woodson, and I just want to welcome all of you for coming. We thought that it would make sense for us to give Alan a little bit of a chance to talk about this lawsuit. Before we do that, I just want to give you a little bit of background about where we are. Drummond Woodson is a law firm that genuinely represents the Portland School Department, but we have great honor of representing Alan and the Portland School Department. We're doing this on a pro bono basis. In this particular case, we have sued the National Endowment of Arts because, as you know, they have prevented Alan from participating in the National Poetry Out Loud contest. Basically, our legal theory here is that the Constitution of the United States gives Alan the right to participate in this contest in the same way that every other public school student can do. And to us and to the Portland School Department, that's a really important thing, and that's why we brought this lawsuit. So the way the lawsuit will work is we filed in federal court. We've asked for a temporary restraining order asking the court to allow Alan to participate, just to participate in the contest. The court has scheduled a hearing for tomorrow afternoon to set a schedule. We'll have briefing, and then I hope to have an order by the court pretty quickly. So with that, I'd like to introduce Alan.
First of all, I'd like to thank Drummond Woodson, my school, my principal, my students, my fellow students at school that have gone above and beyond. They have been so supportive from the start of the competition at the school level, all the way up to the nationals. And one of the most amazing things my principal did, Mr. Palmer here, was organize a school, a fan bus. Anyone who wanted to come support me at the state finals would come through, and they came through, and that just made me feel special. And I did my best. I made my school proud. And one of the things is I love America. I wouldn't be here. I didn't even know about this program in the first place, but America has given me this opportunity. I didn't know about Poetry Out Loud and me expressing myself in other people's words. I think Poetry Out Loud is a wonderful platform, and I didn't know it was going to come to this decision where we have to sue them for not allowing me to participate. And honestly, I just don't want to stir up any trouble. I just want to go to Washington, D.C., just like any other kids from any other state, and perform. And just by doing that, it'll grant me, it'll definitely mean the world to me. Yep.
So, if people have questions,
can you talk a little bit about how it felt for you to win this competition just statewide and to find out that you were going to go to the national competition only to kind of have that taken away from you? Can you talk about that a little bit?
When I first started off at the school level, I was like, okay, I won school level. Then it went on to regionals, like, okay, I now won I was one of the finalists. And when it got to the state level, I was nervous, and I have been practicing with a lot of teachers at my school. They have been putting in, helping me in a lot of ways, and yeah, it was just a great feeling. I felt so proud of myself. I think I represented my school in the best way, and if given an opportunity to go to Washington, D.C., I think I'm going to do the same thing for my state.
How long have you been here in Maine and also the United States?
Less than a year.
Can you talk about why you left Zambia and how you happened to choose Maine as the place to come to?
We really want to focus on the contest and Alan's experiences here in the U.S. Rather than his past.
Can you talk about how you first got involved in poetry then? Like where?
Uh,
did that just start here at Deering High School?
It did. So I had little or no information about poetry out loud. All the credit goes to Ms. Callahan, my teacher at Deering High School. I was just seated and she told me, hey, you want to try this? I was like, yeah, sure. And who knew that I was going to be state champion?
But I guess I meant poetry in general, not the contest. But
poetry?
Were you a reader of poetry or a lover of poetry?
I have always loved poetry, but I did not know about poetry recitation. I did not know you can recite other people's poems. So when I got here and got to learn about poetry out loud, I think it was a perfect fit. Yeah.
What was your initial reaction when you heard, no, you can't go?
Honestly, I felt discriminated against. Because I think I should be given an equal opportunity as any other kid out there. I mean, if you have won something and you deserve something, there should be no barrier in between your success and where you are now.
How does it feel for you to have such strong support from the school district, your teachers? How does it feel for you?
It feels right, I think. Yep, it just feels right. I think we're doing the right thing.
What do you have to say to the national competition that is potentially barring you from this competition?
What?
What do you have to say to the national organization that's potentially barring you from this competition?
What do I have to say to them? I mean, I don't see a reason why I shouldn't go to Washington, D.C. I think I should be given, like I said, I think I should be given an equal opportunity as any other kid.
Can you give me some background on, I guess, kind of when you found out that you wouldn't be able to be a part of this, or when you kind of figured that out in the rules?
It was after I was one of the five finalists, and we were given this paper that we had to check. Some box, and there was one of the statements said you have to be an American citizen or permanent resident with a valid taxation card or social security. So that's where the hump was. So that's the time I figured that it was not going to be easy.
Did you guys have any discussion? Like, did you talk with your teachers or principal about, you know?
Yeah, we did.
What did you talk about?
We talked. By that time, I did not have the social security or the work authorization, which I applied for, but we didn't. Couple weeks, everything came through, and we thought it was going to be fine, and we should try.
So, can I just jump in there for a minute? And just the timeline was that initially the issue was raised with the Maine Arts Commission, and we were able to talk with the Maine Arts Commission, and they agreed to let Alan participate, notwithstanding the rule. I think they believing also that it was a violation. So there's a rule. The Maine Arts Commission decided to allow Alan to participate. And I think now the question is the Maine Arts Commission going to be allowed to send Alan to Washington?
Another question for you. This is coming up fairly soon. How quickly do you expect this process to move? It's a pretty tight deadline.
It has to move very quickly, and we're lucky that our federal court is a hard-working court that will put the resources into this to make a decision and really look at the law. So I think that by this time next week, certainly there will be a decision. I'm hopeful that it will be as early as possible, because Alan needs to practice with a poet.
Yep.
He needs to get to Washington and get some rest and get ready. So that's what we want to have happen.
Can Alan talk about how he happens to go to pick Deering High School to go to if he lives in Westbrook? Or why? Is there any particular reason why he picked Deering?
Because Deering's awesome.
But I just mean coming from another country, how would you know? I don't know if you had somebody had recommended it or friends there or
it just felt right. When I chose the school, it just felt right. It was a perfect fit.
We reached out to the National Endowment for the Arts for comment on this. They said they couldn't because of the restraint that you put on. Have they reached out to you about the process so far?
Are you asking me?
It's kind of a blanket statement to anyone that would answer it.
So we initially, before filing this lawsuit, it was really important to us to find out if there was a good reason for the rule that the National Endowment of Arts is imposing in this case. And we took them a long time to get back to us, and they were not able to articulate any type of a rule. And because they weren't, we were clear with them that litigation would follow. So since then I haven't heard anything from them.
Can you tell me kind of what has been your full communication with the NEA at this point? I guess when did they first even let you know, kind of I guess after you became champion, that you wouldn't be able to go, and then kind of what has been your conversations with them so far?
So I think it's not entirely clear, because I know that you've gotten a couple of emails that almost look like you're going, haven't you? From the Arts Commission. So I mean the National Endowment of Arts has always been clear that Alan doesn't qualify and he's not going to be coming. And that's really all I can say as soon as the state contest was decided.
And then when you tried to actually ask them about it, they kind of, what were their responses?
So their first response was, we'll get back to you. And their second response was, yeah, we'll get back to you soon. And I think it took a few of those responses, and then the response was, well, we have the discretion to enact what rules we want to enact. And this is a rule that we use across the board, and it's really good to have consistency. To my mind and to our mind, that isn't enough to justify a rule that draws some discriminatory lines. And so that's the basis of the lawsuit.
To take a 90-degree turn, is there any chance that we could get Alan to give us a sample of, is it a single poem that he uses for this competition, or is it something, is there a video that we can have?
So I have clips of his performance of the state competition. I have watched them 50 times and I cry every time. So I commend them to you, and if you want, I'd be happy to send them to you.
Can we tell them the three poems though, if just what they are?
So my first poem is The Song of the Smoke by W.E.B. Du Bois. And my second poem was She Walks in Beauty by Lord Byron. And the third poem I did was In the Desert by Stephen Crane.
Can you give us a sample?
Just the beginning.
Oh, which one?
To any
just beginning.
Yes. You feel comfortable
just putting
it in
answers.
A corner, but
mm-hmm.
It would be
nice to practice.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll do the She Walks in Beauty because it reminds me of my mom. And okay, She Walks in Beauty by Lord Byron, George Gordon. She walks in beauty, like the night of cloudless climes and starry skies, and all that's best of dark and bright meet in her aspect and her eyes, thus mellowed to that tender light which heaven to gaudy day denies. One shade the more, one red the less, had half impaired the nameless grace which waves in every raven tress, or softly lightens o'er her face, where thoughts serenely sweet express how pure, how dear the dwelling place. And on that cheek, and o'er that brow, so soft, so calm, yet eloquent, the smiles that win, the tints that glow, but tell of days in goodness spent, a mind at peace with all below, a heart whose love is innocent.
Thank you.
Yep, that's it.
How did you happen to pick that poem?
So, picking my poems, I had help from my teachers, and I did not want to sound the same in all three poems. I wanted to show that I can be diverse in every way. And so you cannot do all three love poems because you sound the same. So you have this, you have Lord Byron, you know, proclaiming black power, and you have the lover boy, the Lord Byron, with this wonderful poem about a woman, and you have Stephen Crane, this short but powerful poem. So I thought those three poems were just like the perfect.
Are you a senior?
I'm a junior.
You're a junior.
Yeah.
Are you already thinking about colleges? Do you think that going to a national competition like this would look pretty good? Is that something that's kind of driving you as well? Plus, there are awards and things like that, are there stipends?
The major thing driving me is the passion I've had for poetry. And if colleges or prize, whatever, they can follow, but the main thing that is driving me, and the reason I'm doing this is because of the love I've had for poetry. Yeah. Yeah, sure.
And what is it that you love so much about it? Like, what is it, I don't know, how does it make you feel, or what does it let you do or think about that no other activity lets you do or think about?
I have, when I'm reading a poem or trying to memorize a poem, I try to think about what the poet was thinking when writing that poem. I know it sounds complicated, but yeah. That's what I try to take that in, what was going on through his head, and I just try as much as I can to bring the poem to life.
And I'm sorry, you are?
I'm David Gallen. I've been a supporter of Alan. He's a member of our family in many ways.
You, am I right in guessing for seeing that you got emotional while it was going on?
I always do when he does that.
Why is that?
The power that he brings to the poet, the poetry is unlike anything, and the difference between Alan sitting on the couch watching a baseball game and Alan reciting the poetry is pretty powerful.
So I was just going to say that I think that's a great way to end this, and a great illustration of why it's so important that somebody who is this talented is able to go and compete in a contest like every other student in America. That's important. That's the reason for this lawsuit. And thank you all for coming.